Wherever you find yourself this Sunday as we continue to navigate the ups and downs of the pandemic, please know that our prayers are with you, and we trust that God's grace is with us all as we journey together through this thing called COVID-19. We hope that this service will bring you spiritual nourishment as we continue going forward. Our service today begins with a hymn, number 385, and please, we can't sing here, but you can sing along at home. 385, Worship the Lord in the Beauty of Holiness. Who are here in person, I invite us to stand. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal Father, who at the baptism of Jesus revealed him to be your Son, anointing him with the Holy Spirit, keep your children, born of water and the Spirit, faithful to their calling. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We are attentive now to the proclamation of God's holy word.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flames shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my sight and honored, and I love you, I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away, and my daughters from the end of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. The word of the Lord. Our psalm is Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders, the Lord over mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Sirion like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord causes the oaks to whirl and strips the forest bare. And in his temple all say, glory! The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as king forever. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace. A reading from Acts. Now when the apostles at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent Peter and John to them. The two went down and prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit. For as yet the Spirit had not come upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then Peter and John laid their hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hands to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary. The chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove, and a voice came from heaven. You are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise.
May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, tornadoes are not that rare these days. And one such tornado lifts off the roof of a house in Barry's Bay very early one morning, picks up the bed on which Bishop Michael and his wife Susan are sleeping, and sets them down gently in Pembroke. When Susan starts to cry, Bishop Michael tries to comfort her. "Don't be scared, darling," he says. "We're not hurt." But Susan continues to cry. "I'm not crying because I'm scared," she says. "I'm crying because I'm happy. This is the first time in years we've been out together somewhere other than the church." Recently, I watched a documentary on trees, the importance of trees, the symbiotic nature of trees, and how they sustain the life around them and are critical to the life of the planet. Trees are critical to our very lives. We're so ignorant of the natural world in which we live. I mean that about all of us, unless you're a biologist or someone who has studied the science of nature, you might be a little less ignorant. But there's so much more that we don't yet know about our precious natural world, about the interconnectedness of everything. This world that God created is so much more miraculous than anyone can possibly realize in our limited human condition. And so, yes, we are mostly ignorant of the miraculous, complex, life-giving design of our natural, God-given world. When I was reading today's Psalm 29, I was thinking, if we understand so little of this amazing world that we can relate to with our sense of sight, sound, touch, taste, and smell, how much more ignorant are we of the amazingness and depth of God, of the divine reality that we can't perceive with our senses? Unless you're a mystic or someone with a profound gift of discernment, we are also ignorant of the immense cosmic splendor of God. Thank God Jesus came to give us a clearer example, a human model of what God is like, God's amazingness. Thank God for the gift of baptism, through which we enter into a deeper relationship with God. And thank God we have Scripture as a constant reminder of the amazingness of God. The psalmist penetrates our ignorance when he says, "Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Worship the Lord in holy splendor." Do we really need to be reminded that our God is all glory and strength? Obviously, yes, we do need constant reminders. If we can so ignorantly continue to abuse our natural world, which is drenched in the glory and splendor of God, then clearly we don't understand God in all his glory and splendor. St. Augustine says, "There is nowhere that God isn't." If we truly understood this, we would recognize the sacredness of all life. We would be working to safeguard the preciousness of our natural world and every human life, for we are all made in God's image. Read today's passage from Isaiah. The prophet Isaiah reminds us that it is God who created us. It is God who protects, redeems, and saves us. And Jesus' very name means the one who saves. So why? Why did God create this amazing planet and all life, including us? Why did he send Jesus to save us from our sins. Because God loves us, we are precious in His sight. The whole world, our planet, is precious in God's sight. Isaiah speaks the word of God. He was speaking to the Israelites, but the word is for us as well. Through Isaiah, God says, "You are precious in my sight and honored, and I love you. Do not fear, for I am with you." Through baptism, as modeled by Christ, through the gift of baptism, we are adopted into Christ's family. And God says through Isaiah, "O everyone who is called by my name," and through our baptism we are called and sealed in the name of Christ, "everyone whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made, I am with you." Today we celebrate the baptism of Christ. Today's gospel reading from Luke's gospel tells us about the baptism of Jesus. Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist. We might think it odd that Jesus should be baptized at all. After all, he was righteous and sinless and had no need to be purified. But John had a genuine calling to this ministry, one that Jesus recognized and sought out. As Jesus explained to John, "It is proper for us to do this, to fulfill all righteousness." By being baptized, Jesus was identifying with the people. He was also identifying with the Father and the Holy Spirit. God's voice from heaven publicly announced Jesus as God's Son, and the Holy Spirit came down upon him as a dove. So Jesus' baptism was a public affirmation of his messiahship by the testimony that came directly from heaven. Jesus was around 30 years old when all this was happening, and his ministry was just beginning. He was the new kid on the block. Every once in a while, a rabbi would come along who was teaching and interpreting the Torah in a new way. To have a new understanding of Scripture that differed from previous rabbis was rare and extraordinary. So people would have been asking, how do we know if what Jesus is saying is true? How do we know that this new rabbi isn't crazy? Apparently, one of the protections for the rabbi was that two other rabbis with authority would lay hands on the new rabbi and validate him. They would be saying, "We believe this rabbi has authority to make new interpretations." So that's another reason why Jesus' baptism is so important. We see John the Baptist, a powerful teacher and accepted prophet in his own right, vouching for the authority and stature of Jesus. John was saying publicly that he wasn't even worthy to untie Jesus' sandals. And to top it off, the voice from heaven said, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The baptism of Jesus marked the beginning of his journey to the cross. Our baptism marks the beginning of our faith journeys with Christ. God is with us through Christ, through the Holy Spirit, through God's presence in all of creation and in every moment and every breath. We are immersed in the glory of God, and we are precious in God's eyes. And you are all precious in my eyes, which makes it all the harder to say what I must now say. My journey with Christ has brought me through nearly 18 years of ordained ministry. But this chapter of my life is now drawing to a close, and I will be retiring as of March of this year. March 13th, 2022 will be my last Sunday. I have been the incumbent of the parish of Eganville for 9 years and an associate incumbent of the parish of the Valley for the past 4 years. I'm encouraged and heartened by all that we have achieved over these past several years at the Church of the Ascension in Killaloe and St. John's in Tremore and at St. John's in Eganville. And now with all of you since the launch of our new Parish of the Valley. It's remarkable, really, what we have accomplished together, despite some of the setbacks that have occurred through circumstances beyond our control. COVID closures and restrictions, obviously, being one of them. I have learned to love you all in this school of love that the author Brian McLaren calls the church. But I feel strongly that the time has come for me to step back and begin a new chapter in my life, just as you will all begin a new chapter in your lives as we all emerge from this latest wave of the COVID virus. I know that I'm leaving you in the very capable hands and hearts of the Reverends Jillian and Matthew, and Bishop Michael. The team and Bishop Shane are all very supportive. Bishop Shane sends us his blessing and support as he works to arrange for a successor. All I can say at this time is thank you. Thank you for all that we have shared together, for many wonderful years of shared worship and service. My ministry would have meant very little without your love and generosity and patience and humor and without your strong faith and prayer. Thank God for the interconnectedness of all life. Through God's Spirit, we are all one body, no matter where we may find ourselves. And through prayer, we shall remain connected. May we respond to the challenges that lie ahead in 2022 with a renewed determination to love and serve our Lord Jesus Christ, however and wherever he may call us. May God bless the Parish of the Valley, each and every congregation, each and every one of you. Thanks be to God, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
For those of us who are here in person, I invite us to stand as we're able. Mindful of that great school of love that we call the church, and for the love that binds us together, no matter what, as brothers and sisters in Christ, let us now renew our baptismal vows on the Sunday of the baptism of the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In water, your Son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we celebrate our fellowship in him in faith. We pray that all who have passed through the water of baptism may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Dear friends, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may rise with him to a new life. Let us renew the promises we made in baptism, when we rejected Satan and all his works, and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ? Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ as the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers? I will, with God's help. Will you persevere in resisting evil, and, whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? I will, with God's help. Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? I will, with God's help. Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? I will, with God's help. Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being? I will, with God's help. Will you strive to safeguard the integrity of God's creation and respect, sustain, and renew the life of the earth? I will, with God's help. God, the Creator, the rock of our salvation, has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, may he keep us faithful to our calling, now and forever. Amen. The prayers of the people. I invite you to stand, sit, or kneel at home, as is your custom for prayer. Let us pray.
The response for the prayer, Lord, in your mercy, is hear our prayer. For peace from on high and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord, Lord, in your mercy. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord in your mercy. For our bishops, especially Shane, our diocesan bishop, and Bishop Michael, for all our clergy, Canon Susan, Matthew, Jillian, and people, let us pray to the Lord in your mercy. For Elizabeth, our queen, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord in your mercy. For this city of Pembroke, for every city and community, and for those who live in them in faith, let us pray to the Lord in your mercy. for those who travel by land, water, or air, for the sick and the suffering, especially those in our bulletin today, those on our hearts, and those known only to you, Lord, for prisoners and captives, and for their safety, health, and salvation, let us pray to the Lord in your mercy. For our deliverance from all afflictions, strife, and need, let us pray to the Lord in your mercy. For all who have died, remembering especially Lois Scott, let us pray to the Lord in your mercy. Remembering all the saints, we commit ourselves to one another and our whole life to Christ, our God. We lift all these prayers to you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Just before I continue with the prayer over the gifts, I just want to say a few words, and I want to speak to our dear Canon Susan. I know that I speak for everyone in the Parish of the Valley when I say that your message concerning your retirement today comes with mixed emotions. On the one hand, we, I think, will all feel a sense of loss as you leave active full-time ministry among us, because Susan, you have served with such great distinction for all those many years, both in the parish that you served and in the our area parish since, and in so many other ways. You have touched so many lives. You have touched us all so richly and so beautifully. And so we will feel a real sense of loss as you come to retire. And I know that that will particularly be true of the people that you've served for many, many years here in this area. But we also are feeling a real sense of blessing and thanksgiving for your ministry, and a sense of joy for you that you may have such a well-deserved retirement. We just pour out our love and our very best wishes and our congratulations to you as you come to this retirement. And to all of us in the Parish of the Valley, please know that this, yes, will be a time of transition, but know that our clergy team is strong. We have all been working together throughout the parish, and we are going to continue to work with our bishop to make sure that this transition period is a smooth one, and that going forward, we will continue to build this Parish of the Valley in a way that I know God has planned for us. So we, as a clergy team, are committed to that. We are committed to you, and we will be here to serve you in every way possible. God of life and freedom, we celebrate the revelation of Jesus as the Christ who makes all creation new. Accept all we offer you this day and make us new in Him who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give knowledge of salvation in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Now with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation, in calling Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the Word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ, and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new, and bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We being many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. the gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Gracious God, lover of all, by this sacrament you make us one family in Christ your Son, one in the sharing of his body and blood, one in the communion of his Spirit. Help us to grow in love for one another and come to the full maturity of the body of Christ. We ask this in his name. Amen.